This opening contest is scheduled for one fall!
Yes.
I'm never going to get tired of that.
Yeah, it's always fun.
We the tool that you can't measure up to.
This wow.
Sucker stay heating, got our middle
fingers up to. We had a ladies and gentlemen,
up to. We
introducing first, this from the Yakuza District in Japan, representing BCW. Weighing at 275 pounds at a height of
6'9". Game slicing, evil words, bring the katana style out. Been known to pull it like Hiroto's trigger finger, poison like.
Wow, I'm very impressed already. Oh, and his opponent. From Medina, Ohio, representing UFW, weighing at 230 pounds at a height of 7'1", Musty Rhoda! Gotta get it right back.
Yes, finally you got the name right. But yeah, Dusty is our resident, as I mentioned earlier, our residential powerhouse.
Well, 230 pounds, Dusty Rhoda taking on 275 pounds, Hiroshi Tatsu. They're nearly the same height. Look at that. Look at the size of the both of them.
Oh yeah, they're quite big.
Indeed, Dusty will not be having a size advantage tonight.
Here we go, our referee today, folks, for the whole show is WPWF's own Rail James. Making sure both of these competitors are ready. And here we go, day two is underway. Dusty Rhoda and Hiroto Katsu. Hiroto offering a handshake to Dusty.
Ah, yes, just what I like to see. A good old handshake of respect.
Oh, great, not that shit again.
What?
Nothing.
No. No. She wasn't ready.
And here we go, locking up straight away.
Ready. Well, yeah, locking up. Hiroto taking charge in this match already. Oh, and going for a hammerlock and a hammerlock strike.
Ooh.
And now in a side headlock is Hiroto Katsu with a very impressive furry outfit, furry avatar, excuse me, but taking down. Oh, bless you. Taking down Dusty Rhoda, and Dusty is in trouble early in this match.
No, she's the one that gets the upper hand early, but not in this case.
And now Dusty throwing Hiroto to the ropes. Here comes Hiroto, but no, getting hit with a big boot by Dusty Rhoda.
it's even worse if you get hit by a hoof.
Oh, it's... I don't even want to imagine.
Yeah, it's not a pleasant experience. You know, they always say you never want to get kicked by a horse, you know?
Fucking bullshit!
And now Dusty Rhoda picking up Bloodbound.
All those punches.
And what is he? What kind of... Excuse me for saying it like this, but what kind of animal is he?
He's a griffin.
He's a griffin. Wow, that's... Yeah. It's really impressive. Either way, what's even more impressive is that catch fallaway slam by Dusty.
Indeed.
Picking up the 275-pounder.
This goes to show, Dusty is very strong.
She's only 230 pounds herself and showing a lot of that power against Hiroto. Throwing Hiroto to the corner.
I have seen Dusty Rhoda gorilla press heavy wrestlers.
As have I, just...
Wouldn't that be called a horse press? That's actually
you
a
know
really
what we mean.
And his corn punches in the corner. Dusty needs to watch out. Oh!
Oh!
And a pop-up knee by Hiroto, creating a moment of recovery. But there goes there goes Dusty going to the other side of the corner being thrown by Hiroto. But here comes Hiroto.
Ooh.
So if she was not serious, would this be horseplay? Says Coy.
Possibly.
Oh, dear.
I love you, Koi. Wow. But Hiroto, once again in the corner, Dusty trying to fight her way out.
Nasty chops there from Hiroto, and down goes Dusty.
Ow! I heard that from over here.
God dang.
I don't know if anyone would want to do that.
And Dusty getting up in the corner. Hiroto waiting for her. Going at her again. Watch out, Dusty. That corner, and that looks like a pin if I've ever seen one. One, two, and no, only two.
Okay. Koi! Punch him in the where?
Uh-oh.
You know, with a Hiroto, that could have two different meanings.
Exactly.
He missed what happened. It looks like it was a standing moonsault from Hiroto and tried another pin. But again, Dusty able to kick out, but she's right there at the ropes. She probably could have easily...
Oh, dear.
Grab the ropes. But what is Hiroto doing? He's on the other side of the ring. Oh, excuse me. No.
He's going to be flying.
He's got those wings for a reason. There he goes. Splash into a power bomb from Dusty Rhoda. Damn it.
You'll get the name right someday.
Eventually.
Oh, Sounds like Hiroto is not happy with how that turned out.
Yes, and...
Oh my god, look at the power! The power of Dusty Rhoda! Picking up the 275-pounder Hiroto! Oh my god! With that... She's letting the blood drain from Hiroto's head.
Hiroto's just like, wait!
And...
Just
a suplex!
The raw strength and power that is Dusty Rhoda on full display right there.
Mm-hmm. Dude, watch your language. Sheesh.
What's your fucking language?
Dude!
What? Dusty and Hiroto give it all in our opening match on day two of this memorial show.
Oh, indeed.
Sending Hiroto to the ropes. Here he comes, and Dusty. She gonna do? Oh, sending Hiroto back to the ropes again. Here we go.
Oh. He's in the corner.
Sending him into the corner now.
Well, one thing I can honestly say, I don't care if you're a wrestler or if you're a five-year-old. You never want to be in a corner.
Die against Dusty Rhoda. Almost the...
No betting.
Oh, get over it.
Oh!
Nice stinger splash from Dusty Rhoda.
The life of a kitty cat, getting petted a lot.
And the crowd's asking one more time.
Oh!
Oh! They're not going to get it because the referee said out, and Dusty Rhoda suplexes Hiroto out of the corner.
I'm sure she'll find some way to be plucking his feathers. And frankly, with some of her moves, I would be surprised if she did.
Uh-oh. And now Hiroto, trying to make a comeback here. Oh, sword kick!
No!
Hiroto caught two. Now he's thinking about going flying one more time.
Oh, dear.
And this could be it.
Not good for Dusty.
Oh, she's getting up!
Hiroto better make his move quickly. Dusty is getting up.
Yeah, that could easily...
And here comes Hiroto!
What?
The massive jackhammer from Dusty Rhoda! Oh my god, it's
over!
That's three!
That was impressive!
Hiroto out of the air and slamming him down in a jackhammer. Wow.
I'll just say, pardon my language, but holy shit, that was crazy.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Dusty Rhoda.
Wow, the crowd sure is being a bit vicious towards Hiroto at the moment.
That was quite a match. I rather enjoyed that.
Just going crazy. This is a great, great opening match as well. But the winner, of course, is Dusty Rhoda. And Hiroto Katsu has been very impressive this entire match.
What?
Oh,
What a great match.
Indeed, indeed. That was quite a lot of power in that match. Love it.
The people, stop talking about chicken. You're going to make this kid hungry.
Make me hungry, too.
Just to think, some tasty chicken with some chipotle barbecue sauce.
Introducing first from Queens, New York, representing FPW and BCW, weighing at 166 pounds at a height of 5'9", Joanne Steele.
But you didn't think that I'd come back to life.
We feel half human, believing only half of what's and in our heads. Introducing her opponent, feels half crazy. From Cincinnati, Ohio, representing RWA, weighing at 140 pounds at a height of 5'11".
Everybody calls us long shots, living for another lost cause. Everybody calls us dreamers, shooting at the sun like it's all we got, you know. Everybody feels half crazy, half of the time you said, but we'll never be half-hearted again. Cause even when it seems so hard, we are our hearts. And even when we see our stars, we are our hearts. Cause you made up the other.
All right. Referee checking, both shaking their.
Looks like June's got Joanne in a headlock.
Yeah, that's right. June taking control early in this match, putting June down that headlock.
Oh my.
Really?
What?
No, none.
Okay.
Oh, June, oh. That headlock combo.
Impressive.
Oh.
Oh, my.
Oh, now they're sizing each other up.
So if you guys would like to get your catfight gestures ready, I think we are about to see what we like to call across the street over at WPWF.
a cat fight. And here we go.
Ooh,
and now Joanne working on the arms of June Gloom.
Oh boy.
Ooh. And now Joanne wow. Some very impressive technical work from Joanne Steele.
Mm-hmm.
Putting June down. Oh, I'm gonna have trouble talking today.
You'll be fine.
And putting her down in a side headlock of her own, Joanne Steele, on June Gloom.
Sometimes you just got to return the favor.
Yeah, anything you can do, I can do better, basically.
Yeah, pretty much.
And now
that
picking
is
her
true.
Up and we're back in a... Ooh. Oh, a slap. Oh, all right, get it ready. Oh.
Oh.
That. Oh.
Oh.
Ooh. What? Nasty.
The nasty chops.
Oh. Ouch.
Joanne Steele working on the legs of June Gloom, June Gloom working on the legs of Joanne Steele. Ooh, and again working on the leg, kicking her thigh. And again, working on the legs. It's a very smart move for June Gloom, working on those legs. Because both competitors, June and Joanne, they're strikers and they're high flyers at the same time. So, you know, taking the legs off, that's a lot of their,
Whoa,
a small package.
Uh-oh, 1, 2, and no, only 2.
She was luckily able to break out of it.
A sneaky roll up.
Getting a little surprise roll up.
It's just like a ha, sneak attack.
June trying to get into the head of Joanne. And now, oh, a nice shoulder block from June. Putting down Joanne Steele. But Joanne just getting right back up, waiting for more. Here she comes, June Gloom. Big boot from Joanne Steele, putting down the chill factor.
That's gotta hurt.
Whew. Osbury flop.
My.
Oh, Fosbury flop from Joanne Steele onto June Gloom. And Joanne trying to get into this, trying to get back into this match, trying to stay on top of June.
Oh.
And Joanne with those kicks, it looked like. Oh, going for a pin. 1, 2, and no. Again, only 2.
Nice combination of kicks and punches, but it's not quite enough to make that a 3 count.
Yeah.
Yes, more of the punching, please.
I was wondering when you were going to say that.
Oh, hey, I happen to be a connoisseur of the punching, so sue me.
I know you're a connoisseur. It's like you're a connoisseur with your scotch.
Joanne Steele sending June into the corner. What's she getting ready to do here?
Pain train.
Kick. June Gloom to Joanne Steele, trying to create some breathing room here.
Well, the pain train has been officially derailed.
Indeed. Nasty cyclone kick. I bet Joanne is seeing little Tweety birds right now.
I wouldn't be surprised on that one.
Fuck! And now June, this time throwing Joanne into the corner. Oh, and Joanne,
Oh, God.
Oh. Those head scissors.
Oh,
there we go. Head scissors takedown.
Right into the turnbuckle. Ouch.
And that is June Gloom for you, ladies and gentlemen. Very exciting to watch.
Ooh.
Oh, and a penalty kick just to make it worse.
Oh, I heard that from here.
So did I.
And can Joanne capitalize? Taking a little while to go for the pin. Here we go. One, two, and
nope.
No.
Oh, Joanne still has some in the tank.
Oh yeah.
Well, June Gloom taking a little longer than usual going for the pin instead of capitalizing right away. She probably missed a chance to win this match.
Yeah, but oh well.
Took a little too much time, but Joanne Steele still in trouble. Toe kick. June. Super kick from Joanne Steele after June goes off the ropes.
Now let's see if Joanne can capitalize and turn this match around.
Hopefully she can.
Trying to make a comeback, but I don't think that's going to be enough to keep June Gloom down. And Joanne might agree. Picking her up.
Ooh!
Oh! And she calls this the Three Amigos! Ooh!
That's definitely
going to hurt. To finish that off, and Joanne is fired up.
Looks like that might have just been the opening Joanne needed to get the momentum in her favor.
And now Joanne climbing to the top of the turnbuckles, planning on flying.
Oh boy.
What is she thinking about doing here? And here she comes!
Oh!
Frog splash onto June Gloom. Can she capitalize? Come on, Joanne, you can pin her.
She's right there.
There she goes for the cover.
And going for the pin. One, two, no, only two again.
I swear, this is really becoming one hell of a nail biter.
Indeed, this is looking like it's going to come down to whoever runs out of gas first.
Mm-hmm.
You had best unfuck yourself, or I will unscrew your head and chip down your neck!
Oh my.
And now Joanne Steele thinking about... No! It is Joanne Steele with that Kirifuda driver going for the pin. One, two.
Nope.
But no.
June almost able to put Joanne away there. Not quite, although it's looking like June might be starting to run out of gas.
I'm gonna give you 3 seconds.
exactly 3 fucking seconds.
It was almost hard to call. I was almost confused as to what even happened. June, Cindy, Joanne to the corner.
Uh-oh.
Setting Joanne up. And June and Joanne. Oh! Oh! Top rope hurricanrana from June Gloom. But she can't capitalize. She can't capitalize, and she's right there.
Looks like she's feeling it pretty badly, too, after that. Although she is able to get up, but not going for the pin.
She should have.
A huge opportunity wasted here.
I'm just like, what are you doing? Pin right there. It's right there.
And Joanne is now getting up.
Joanne trying to get back up. June Gloom waiting in the corner. Oh, and here comes Joanne. Oh, June, excuse me. Oh, she dodges. Joanne dodges.
Oh.
And Joanne, what is she going to do? The old cab driver. She's got her. She got her down.
This has to be it. This has to be it.
1, 2, 3. Well, stick a fork in her. She's done, folks.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Joanne Steele.
June almost had that there, but just ran out of gas. Wasn't able to capitalize. But Joanne was.
What a great match we just witnessed.
Oh, yes.
That was one hell of a match. I must say, I thoroughly enjoyed that.
Now is the time. Oh my, there is a lot of people here. Hello everybody. Now is the time. It's the moment we've all been waiting for the dance off. So now we're going to choose 3 random people from the crowd to come up into this ring and show us your dance moves. So who would like to volunteer themselves to dance? Anybody at all, anybody. Anybody, Marionetta, do you want to come into the ring? How about Ash up there? You want to get into this ring, Ash? Ash and Vivian, how about the both of you come down into this ring? Come on.
Oh, boy.
Stu, I see you up there. Stu, come on. Let's get you in the ring. I know you got some dance moves. We saw those dance moves.
Down here. Who just signed his own
Come on, Ash.
What have we got here? A fucking comedian.
Anybody else? Anybody? Anybody at all? We're looking for three people. We got Ash. We got Vivian. Do you want to get into this ring? Come on, Vivian. Who else is here? Koi? Mina? Carmelita? Marionetta? Trixie?
You know what? Fuck it.
Ray? I see I'll you, come. Ray.
I'll come in.
We need one more person. Anybody. Anybody at all. Koi! Koi has joined us. All right. So let's get this dance off underway. If you could please play the music that we've selected for this. Oh, we got Benja here too. Benja.
What the hell?
What are you doing here?
That's what I'm wondering.
Oh, well now we got a lot of people.
Eh, fuck it. Why not? Right?
All right, who would like to go first?
That's a good question. Who goes first?
Who would like to go first? If the production could please play the music that was selected for this.
Don't you worry, I've got this in the bag. Here I go.
Nobody told me this was a freaking twerk off. Oh, no. Let's get this on. Yeah. Come on, big boy. Show we got cake. Show them we got cake.
Clear the ring. And play my music.
tell me twice.
Hey, Benja. I think he's having a stroke. Yeah. Ready?
Oh my god. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, wow, what a shit show that was. If you think the winner of this was Ash, let him hear you.
Fine, folks, let him hear you.
If you think the winner was Coy, let her hear you.
Come on, come on.
All right, all right. If you think for any reason at all that this Gunter Hyde won, go, let him hear you.
Oh dear,
and
oh dear.
Last but very much not the least, Benja Nirvana. If you think Benja won,
Benja, congratulations. I think you may have just won this dance off.
Alright.
How can you not with all that twerking and all that flumpy?
I was not expecting the flumpy.
Ya son las 12, ya ven, empieza el jangueo. Para bailarle y entrarle nosotros al festejo.
From Monterrey in Mexico, representing WPWF. With a height of 5'7" and a weight of 139 pounds, let's hear it for
Soledad! I'm about to hit the streets up, and the strip looking lit, I'm about to heat up. Llegó la mami que todo desespera, te deja boca abierta cuando esta negra llega. Oh no, they're trying to keep up, but they're just too slow. They think that I'm the one, but they just don't know. I know I'm going to do my thing, but they know what
I'm going to do. Oh, it was sort of bad when the game's off. It looks like Soledad has been declared clean.
There's one thing that I love in this world, and that is getting on my
way. And her opponent, from France, representing FPW, with a height of 5'3" and a weight of 99 pounds, Lolly Wahan Zihaza!
Barking on my Korea. There was only one thing I know is true. Hey, yeah, put it in the song for you. Doing music and doing what I like, which is going outside every day or night. I just found some jumps in the woods. No, I didn't do them, but I probably could. A better mountain bike is all I'm gonna need. So it's time to save my money up from selling weed. There is only one thing I know is true. Hey, yeah, put it in the song for you. I'm doing music and doing what I like. I'm definitely never gonna fall off my bike.
All right.
And looks like Loli has been declared clean as well.
Yep, seems so.
And there's the bell. Locking up straight away. Ooh.
Oh my.
Well, it died quick on the wrist lock.
Indeed. Oh, whoa. Oh.
And just flipping Loli down with the arm drag takedown there. Got Sully Dodd in a headlock, going in there with a strike to the head there.
Ouch.
Ooh.
And yet another headbutt. Oh!
Tops and then right back into that headlock. Oh!
Oh, dear.
Taking it down to the mat.
Oh, boy.
Sully just in control.
Whoa!
And it's a pin!
But
no, kicks out right away.
Yeah, that was a tad bit too quick.
And now Soledad has Loli in a headlock.
I've heard of playing head games, but not like this.
And following it up with a snap suplex.
Ouch. Okay, I'm just gonna say this. I'm eager to see how this Loli girl fights, since I have never seen her fight before.
Neither have I, and oh, a scoop slam!
Oh!
Soledad just taking control of this match. Going in for the cover. But no, only good for one.
Do you really think it will be that easy?
Whoever said that, those words are so true.
Soledad pacing as Loli starts to get up. For it with that that knee breaker there.
And she definitely felt the pain from the fact I heard her screaming.
Oh, and then gonna follow up with a figure four.
Oh no, not the figure four.
Looks like Loli has Loli Dodd right where she wants her. Loli Dodd refusing to tap, trying to claw her way towards the ropes.
Does she have it? I think she got it.
And she does.
I will not be surprised if Loli is going to take full advantage of that leg being hurt.
It would be a wise strategy to do so.
I mean, it's a wise strategy if you know your opponent has a weak spot. Definitely aim for it.
And Loli just keeping Soledad down with that gator roll.
Ow.
Now going in there with some kicks.
That's gotta hurt.
Nearly knocking Soledad over there with that last one.
Luckily, she didn't kick so hard, her head started flying.
Oh, he's been in charge of this one. Oh! But Soledad with a back body drop.
My goodness.
Going in there. Bumping it in.
Oh ho! Splash right on.
Putting on the pressure, trying to keep the momentum up. Oh. As she goes up to the top rope.
A definite make or break moment.
Oh, and a massive flying splash. One and no.
Lowly
kicks out at one.
Sheesh, what are these two made of? This is nuts.
Soledad now going in there with some brutal chops and a kick. Top rope into a pin. One, two, and no. Not quite.
And I just heard Lola yell, no way.
Ooh, Soledad just going in there with those nasty kicks.
Ooh. And a chop.
Oh!
Oh my.
And a jumping, spinning back kick. Oh, if Loli wasn't seeing Tweety Birds before, she is now.
Oh, no doubt on that one. You can just hear the... around her head. Oh! Oh!
And a rolling thunder as a chaser. Going for the pickup.
Oh,
oh, but Loli able to shove Soledad back. Off to the ropes once more.
Oh, oh, oh!
Nailing that cartwheel back elbow into a pin. It was only good for two. Now off the top rope.
Oh, oh, oh. And another.
Another pin. And again, only good for two.
My goodness. It's starting to come a little
and
bit.
And another pin that's only good for two. Gonna need to do a little more work, I think, before you can pin.
Oh yeah, no doubt. Oh!
And again, the pin. And again. Only good for two.
Good lord. Looks like Loli's not really happy with what the ref has to say.
Well, we better be careful not to get distracted with the ref, though. Because you always want to keep your attention on your opponent!
And she just tossed her like a rag doll.
Soledad working to regain the momentum. Tossing Loli to the corner, now going to the opposite side.
I think it's Patriot time.
Indeed, Soledad punching it coast to coast, sticking on the Patriot with a massive corner slam.
Damn! Ooh!
And just going in there with those knees as the ref counts. Getting out of the corner at three. Coming back with a shining black.
Well, one thing she definitely was bringing it around town.
Holy Dot dragging Loli to the center of the ring. Going after that leg. Going in for the cover. One, two, and no. I think that shoulder is up.
Yep, it's up.
Looks like fatigue is starting to set in on both of them. Loli Dodd back up first. Loli slowly trying to get up.
Oh yeah, it's just a matter of time before who knows which one will run out of gas.
Oh! Loli Dodd not out of gas yet with the La Quebrada.
Now that was impressive. Crowd definitely seems to enjoy that.
And Soledad going back up to the top rope once more. He goes in with a frog splash, but no! Loli rolls away!
Ouch. And she ain't nothing but Matt. That man, what?
I don't know. Loli goes up to the top rope.
And
it's CJ 630 Senton. This could be it.
It could be. Yes. She better capitalize
this
on it now.
This has to be it.
Come on, it's right there. Capitalize on it. Or not.
Oh, okay. She's got her in the O'Connor roll.
One, two, three.
That's it.
Okay. I am going to say it. Loli is impressive.
And your winner by pinfall, Loli.
What is your take on Loli? There was only one thing I
know is true. Oh, she definitely put on an impressive performance out there. Doing what I like, which is going outside every day on my bike.
Indeed she did.
Managing to come out with the win. But so did that put up a great fight, too.
Save my money up from selling weed. There is only one thing I know is true. Heck yeah, put it in the song for you. I'm doing music and doing what I like, which I'm definitely never gonna fall off my bike.
That certainly was a great match. I definitely enjoyed that, and I hope all of you out there in the audience enjoyed that too. That was quite a match.
Oh, it was. Oh, great.
introducing first, being accompanied to the ring by CJ Tyrant, the Last Irish Outlaw, Marza Winlow, the Cyber Enigma, Neon Shadow, and the Dark Siren, Samantha Foxy. Representing FPW with a combined weight of 578 pounds. Looks like they are ready for the action tonight.
This is some familiar music.
Indeed. Here we have Solstice. Yeah. Representing UFW.
The petting.
Here's a question. Have they found their third tag partner?
Man, I really hope so. Neon, what are you doing?
Neon?
Why are you...
is Timogen, also representing UFW, with a combined weight of 425 pounds. Do they have a third member, though?
Okay, cut this music. Look, first off, yes, you stupid wanker. I know I'm not legal in this match. Second off, you guys weren't even able to find a partner, so it's going to be a 3-on-2 match. So why would you, did you have any problems? I mean, this is it. My God, that Solstice looks familiar. But here's the deal. It's 3-on-2. And that's the way it's going to be. And you're going to have a problem with the BCW International Champion, the one and only Neon Shadow, and a person who likes to bake cupcakes and cookies, Samantha Foxy, the Super Shredder herself. So, why don't you come in this ring, take your beating, and let's get this over with. This is coming from the dance-off winner here for tonight.
Hello, Ben.
Huh? Wait, what's this?
Really? Pause it. Pause it.
And looks like Solstice and Timothin are being joined by, from Chicago, Illinois, representing OEW with a weight of 280 pounds and a height of 6'8", Gunter Hyde!
Oh, look. It's Gunter Hyde. This is it.
Sentry mode activated.
Well, there we have it. We have even sides now.
Yes, but here's one thing I'm thinking to myself. I don't know if the French brothers are that well aware of what they're getting themselves into, because we both already know of Solstice and Temujin. They're tough.
Get it numerically even. Once again, this match will be Lucha rules, meaning that if both feet end up on the ground outside the ring, that counts as a tag.
This will be an interesting thing to watch.
Looks like we'll be starting with Baza and Gunter.
Target acquired.
May I help you?
And there's the bell. Manager.
Why I order?
Looks like they are,
Oh!
Baza right out the gate with a shotgun dropkick!
Ouch. That has to hurt.
Gunter looks like he got hit by a freight train!
What?! What
got
the hell?!
And Baza quickly goes in with D's nuts.
Got you!
Oh, come on!
And toss
Are
salad.
You serious? Yes.
Oh dear, oh dear.
Got him!
This is just wrong!
I don't think Gunter was ready for that.
Oh, he definitely wasn't.
Asa backs off in time, though.
I honestly think I need bleach after this. I still gotta get that image out of my head.
And Baza going for a cover. But Gunter kicks out right away. Going for the pickup. Gunter able to push Baza back, and now going in there with some punches. Just punching Baza back towards the corner. Yes, yes. Yeah. More of the punching, please.
Neon!
Yay!
Ugh. Yes, I think they want more.
Hunter working against the clock, though.
Ooh.
And he backs off at three.
Did you see what Neon did?
Uh-oh, Gunter's gone across to the other side.
I think we know what that means.
He's punching the coast-to-coast ticket on the pain train with a stinger splash. And now going in there and just giving Baza the business in the corner.
Oh, yes. I'm sure this will... Like, this is for rubbing your butt all over my face. What the hell?
More of the punching, please. Okay.
What the hell is this? Oh, God!
It's the cheeky Nandos. Oh, dear. That had to hurt.
Oh, my gosh.
How's it going for the pickup? Going in with a Judas effect.
Excuse me? I said no such thing. Don't you be trying to put words in my mouth.
Baza goes in with a stunner and a pin. 1-2, and no, that shoulder is up.
Yeah, nice try, Baza.
Searching.
Are you serious? Oh!
Oh,
is he gonna...
Hunter, what's gonna... with the gorilla press! And just power slams him down! You know Baza is feeling that one.
And he'll probably be feeling that in the morning, too.
Massive leg drop there, and a fist drop as a chaser. And now he's going for the cover. 1-2, and no, not quite. That shoulder's up again.
Oh, no.
This is about the time I think they ought to start thinking about tagging.
Yeah.
Both of them are starting to look a little fatigued.
Oh, geez.
And both sides have two fresh bodies waiting to enter the ring.
Okay, now's not the time for hugging. What? I didn't say that!
Oh! Wow! Baza with a massive backflip DDT. And now just flips Gunter over the ropes. And Gunter's out on the mat.
Well, I guess we know what that means.
Gunter's up on 2 feet. That means the next, his teammate can jump in.
Oh!
With a, oh dear.
Looks like Temujin's going in. Oh, and Neon. Holy cow.
Indeed, since both Gunter and Baza went out and touched the ground with their 2 feet, that means that Temujin and Neon are now the legal men.
Oh!
Oh, and okay. Neon goes for the schoolboy roll up. 1, 2, and no! Temujin is able to kick out. Neon trying to be sneaky. But Temujin was ready for it. Oh! And Temujin just takes Neon down and starts giving him the business with those elbows.
Yes, more of the punch.
Maybe he shouldn't have been all like, come on.
Imogen tossing Neon over to the corner, but he comes back with a rebound sunset flip into a pin once more. 1, 2, and no. Imogen able to kick out again.
Oh, good lord.
Very impressive moves from Neon there.
Yeah, I guess so.
Tossing Imogen to the ropes.
Oh, ho!
But Temujin comes back with a leg lariat.
Ow, 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 ow. Yes, stomp him.
Ow, 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 ow.
Temujin working to keep Neon grounded and now wraps him up in an Indian deathlock.
Wait a minute. What's going on outside the ring? What the?
Oh, I see a table.
Somehow I'm sensing ill intent is going to be used for that.
Illegal operation. He might just have it.
He has
it. And he does.
Well, one thing.
Breaks the hold.
Judging from what I'm seeing, Neon definitely is feeling it.
Pushing Temujin back. And Temujin goes in there and pecks Neon.
What did he call him? He called him a Chinese chicken. Whoever can
swallow the most tolerable. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Temujin is Mongolian. He doesn't take kindly to being called Chinese.
And he's a vulture, not a chicken. Get your animals right.
Ow, 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 ow.
Well, Temujin's always been good at putting that pecker to good use. You don't want to get hit with that thing, trust me.
Oh!
Oh!
But Neon just taking Temujin down and just starts giving him the business!
And someone complains of me having a...
Able to get back up and... Just give him the old pop-up knee strike.
Well, people, stop trying to put words in my mouth. I never said any of that.
Oh, and a nasty Yakuza kick. Imogen off to the cross, ropes across the way, coming across. Oh, but no, Neon gives him the back body drop over the ropes.
Oh,
once Temujin gets up, that will count as a tag.
Yeah.
If you don't behave, I'm gonna have to bonk you with my trident.
Oh!
And
oh,
Neon comes out with an acai moonsault.
Well, Looks like it's Samantha Foxy and Solstice in there. One thing I know for sure, she doesn't know what she's getting herself into going against a superhero.
Well, one thing's for sure, this part of the match is definitely Foxy.
Oh, for crying out loud, are you serious? That was bad and you know it. No Benjo over here. No.
Oh. Let's see, who's gonna...
I'm glad to as well. Let's do this for Kaleri.
Ooh.
Oh.
Oh, indeed. Ooh! This is exactly what I was talking about.
Jesus!
Oh, shoot!
Yes, yes. More of the punching, please.
Oh, my God!
Yes, yes. More of the punching, please.
This is getting crazy. It just went from 0 to 100 so quickly.
Yes, yes. More of the
Oh, God. Oh.
But Samantha able to grab Solstice by the head and give her 3 headbutts.
Ow, ow.
Oh, God.
Ow, ow.
A hat trick, if you will.
Oh, okay. Oh, yes!
Hats go on the head, you know?
Yes, I get it.
And Solstice just giving Samantha the business in the corner.
More of the punching, please.
Getting called out. The count has started.
What the fuck?
Oh, my goodness.
Well, looks like we've got company up here.
No betting.
Solstice just going in there with those kicks.
Oh man, that has definitely gotta hurt. Oh ho ho! Damn!
Nasty Yakuza kick there, and down goes Samantha. And Baza and Timogen having words. As Solstice tosses Samantha over towards the center of the ring.
Well, you have to think, since at the moment they can't fight with their fists, the best they can do is fight with words. That was a too well timed.
I love butter.
Solstice making move to loom over Samantha. Let's see what she has in mind here.
Oh.
He's gonna go for a cover. But Neon comes in and breaks
up. Come on! Are you serious? Yay! Oh my God.
And getting called out on it.
Good.
Like Solstice and Samantha are both not moving.
Oh dear. This ain't good. Oh, wait a minute. Solstice is moving.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, I just can't help but chuckle at the thing going on over there.
Oh, Samantha able to recover though. But ends up in the corner again. Solstice going to the opposite corner.
Look. Oh, pain train time.
Samantha punching a ticket. Comes on the
chugga,
pain
chugga,
train.
Choo, choo, choo.
And again.
Chugga, chugga, choo, choo, choo.
And maybe again a third time.
Chugga, chugga,
third
choo, choo, choo.
Third time's charms, probably.
Oh, and a nasty Yakuza kick.
Oh, God.
And a running face wash. Oh dear.
This is not good.
Gotcha.
Samantha now dragging Solstice away from the corner towards the center of the ring.
Oh.
And going for the cover. One, two, and no. Solstice kicks out in time.
If there's one thing you and I both know about Solstice, she's never one to get up easily.
Real quick, give me this headset.
Hey!
I wanted to let you know that Trixie is secretly in love with the Trench Brothers. Thank you.
Give me that! Get the hell out of here!
Well, today I learned something.
I do not! He's lying! Pains in the asses.
Meantime, Samantha getting a nasty chop and another from Solstice back towards the corner. And Solstice not letting up. Oh!
Oh!
And following it up with a spinning Uranage, and down goes Samantha again.
Oh, goodness.
Solstice looming over Samantha.
Oh, she got her up. Oh! Oh, yes!
And goes for a back suplex. And looks like Samantha slips out of the ring.
Oh dear. Oh, come on! Are you kidding me?
And immediately goes for a choke, getting called on for it. Now, Neon is legal because Samantha went out of the ring.
Oh no.
Oh, Neon setting
up
Solstice in a tree of woe.
That's not
and
very
just
fair.
Stomping a mud hole in her.
Chugga chugga choo choo choo.
Uh-oh. Sounds like Neon wants to...
Oh, no!
Looks like Neon punched a round-the-world ticket on the pain train.
Seems so. Solstice, do something!
Neon locking her up and dragging her out towards the center of the ring.
Oh!
And drop kick right on the knee there.
Oh no, oh no!
Not good. It's the Lucha Cradle. One, two, and no.
Come on, Solstice, you got this. Oh, no.
Get wrecked.
One thing she does have is a face full of kicks right now.
Yes.
And Neon going for the cover. One, two, and no. Solstice still able to get that shoulder up.
Oof. Thank goodness.
Are you still there?
Solstice, come on, get up! Don't let these people take you down.
Oh.
Get wrecked.
Oh, no!
Solstice was able to catch the kick, but Neon able to follow up with a Dragon Whip, and down goes Solstice once more. Just going in there with those kicks again.
Don't you dare touch the mask. Oh!
And taking him down with a Dragon Screw.
Nice.
Looks like Benja is calling for Neon to unmask Solstice.
No. That is a big no-no.
Excuse me.
Ow, 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 ow.
See, what Solstice has in mind here is she locks Neon up.
Hopefully it's something good.
Neon trying to struggle out of it. The Solstice holding firm.
Let's hope she figures out something. Oh god, did you see what Solstice said? She said, so cyber me this, cyber me that. Who's the big dum-dum who just loves to hack?
Well, I mean, I guess. It's true.
Well, obviously.
But Neon, not able to hack his way out of that lock. Oh! But now he just does. He slips out.
Ding, ding, ding. Tell him what he wants.
But Solstice able to lock him back up.
Whoa.
And goes in for a kick.
Yes!
And Solstice with the carry swing.
Ow, 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 ow.
Nicely done, Solstice.
Solstice is still the legal fighter, and she gives Neon the business.
Yes, more of the punching, please.
Well, someone just took the words right out of your mouth.
And tossing him over towards the ropes.
Sentry mode activated.
And now tripping him up with a drop toe hold up against the ropes. Now going across to the opposite rope.
Oh, yes!
And a tiger faint kick. Going for the pin. One, two, and no, not quite.
Hey, what the ref says goes. Deal with it.
Gunter not happy. He was certain that was a three count.
It could have been, but as I said, the ref says goes.
Malfunctioning.
And looks like Rail is going to have some words with Gunter.
Oh, shoot!
And Solstice and Neon start giving each other the business!
Yes, yes, more of the punching, please.
Ah. Oh!
But Neon able to come out on top with that heel kick.
What the? What just happened?
What the fuck?
They're both down.
And it looks like they both managed to land an Inzaghi on each other.
Sheesh.
Total carnage. I love it.
I think they're both really getting worn out there, so.
They're both out. Gunter jumping in along with Samantha.
And we have yet another battle of the sexes.
Asa going to check on Neon. As Gunter and Samantha just stare each other down.
Are yins gonna hit each other or not?
Twist that dick! Twist it through it!
Yes, a moment. Sure.
Whatever that's supposed to mean. Anyway.
They're locked up now.
Ooh!
And Samantha able to come out on top with some chops, but Gunter responding with some of his own.
It's like, I chop, you chop, we all chop. Oh!
And Gunter just tosses Samantha over towards the ropes. But Samantha Ooh. Comes off the ropes with a rebound! Going for the pin. Gunter going for the pickup.
Ooh. Oh. What's this? I think it's time for another thing of pain train.
Indeed, Gunter punching a coast-to-coast ticket. And then gives Samantha snake eyes, but Samantha's able to get right back up. But looks a little dazed.
Seems so.
Gunter comes in and just gives her the big boot.
Right to the kisser.
Ouch.
And a pin.
But it looks like it's only good for one count.
Indeed. Samantha.
Oh, no, wait. The ropes.
The ropes. Yep. Samantha able to.
I didn't notice that. This is getting crazy, I tell you.
And another super kick. And another. Now going for the cover. This one is far from the ropes.
One, two,
and no, not quite. Gunter able to kick out in time.
Oh.
Yeah, that didn't quite work out as expected. And a one. And a two. And that's three. Of the headbutt, I mean. Not the swing. Round and round and round he goes. Where will he stop? I'm afraid I don't know.
Gunter, not happy about it, and now she's going to drop him down and wrap him up in a sharpshooter.
Oh, no.
Gunter not happy, feeling the pain there, screaming out, I can hear him from here.
So can I.
She did.
Is he gonna tap, or is he gonna make it to the ropes? He is giving it his all to getting to the ropes. Can he make it?
We can only hope so.
He's at the ropes.
Hey! Bad touch.
Again, staring each other down, and now... Oh, got you with a choke slam! Oh, Benja, not happy about it, what he just saw. It looks like Neon is up on the top rope.
Oh, come on.
Getting called out for it.
Oh, gosh. This is getting ridiculous.
Gunter better watch his back. His opponent is behind him.
Exactly. If there's one thing that's an obvious, you never take your eye off the opponent at all.
Bonk. Samantha's getting up. Gunter's still looking the other way. Samantha's up!
Yeah. Could have capitalized on that easy. Oh. Wait a minute.
Gunter just picking up Samantha in a gorilla press.
Oh dear. Oh!
And slamming her down with a power slam.
Chugga chugga choo choo choo.
Oh, and I can hear him tell like Fox you to get up.
Oh, Gunter setting up for something. Looks like the Trench Brothers are once again distracting the ref.
That's not very fair.
Well, you knuckleheads, knock it off.
Chugga chugga choo choo choo.
Gunter goes in with the Chicago style. He goes for the cover, but the ref is distracted.
Ref! Leave the be!
Turn around!
There's a fight going on! Pay attention!
He does. She turns around finally. Oh, but it's... But Samantha is able to get the shoulder up in time.
Oh, man.
Get wrecked.
If not for that distraction, Gunter would have had that.
He could have. But of course, the bozos over there decided to start roaring at her.
What do you call that? What do you call that? What are you gonna do? Why were you distracted? We had this one! You...
What the fuck?
Shut the fuck up, you idiot!
Gunter letting himself get distracted by his dissatisfaction with the left jaw, and Samantha with the Jackson in a duster.
Maybe he shouldn't have argued. Oh, I'm just gonna... Gunter, maybe you should do yourself a favor and tag someone else in.
Samantha just tagged Baza, and Gunter goes to tag in Timogen.
Alrighty.
And Timogen just immediately throws Baza down with that nasty Uranaga and just goes in there to pound those stomps
just pounding and pounding Baza into the ground.
Yes, Temujin, yes. Show these trench brothers how tough we UFW people are.
Temujin going in there with the knees and the kicks. He starts to work the leg on Baza.
Oh, yes. He
Baza
is not
accusing
cheating.
Temujin of cheating, but... I mean, I didn't see anything illegal.
Neither did I.
Tossing Temujin to the ropes. Now Temujin tossing Baza to the corner. And he's going to the opposite corner. Temujin punching a coast-to-coast ticket on the pit train with a nasty Yakuza kick.
Yes!
And then following it up with a Michinoku driver. But the pin is not good. Only good for two.
Almost on that one.
Baza now getting up and going in with some kicks of his own.
Why do I sense that Baza is a feathers?
But do you expect anything less from the Trench Brothers?
True.
Baza just taking Temujin down with the knee, and here he comes with a cartwheel knee currency!
Oh, God, no!
Fuck!
Yay!
Bullshit.
Yay!
Fuck!
Temujin, come on!
No standing senton. Baza tossing Temujin over to the corner.
Oh.
Now goes in there to pound him with kicks.
Oh, for crying out loud.
And then goes in there with the running high knee. Not looking good for Temujin right now. As he goes in with a running face watch. Now going across to the opposite corner.
Uh-oh. I sense pain.
Get
wrecked.
Baza punching a coast-to-coast ticket on the pain train.
Chugga chugga choo choo.
Right into Temujin's face.
Ouch. Oh no.
I see plotting going on over there in the Trench Brothers corner.
I knew that table was going to be for ill intent.
Meanwhile, Baza sitting Temujin up on the top rope.
Oh!
And he brings Temujin down with a Coventry
right
one.
On the beak.
Going for the cover. One, two, and no. Temujin gets that shoulder up just in time.
Uh-oh.
Ah! Oh, yes!
Ooh. Temujin, though, on the rebound with the double underhook backbreaker.
Wonderful.
Tossing Baza to the ropes. Then just wisely jumping down in time.
He should have been hit.
Baza able to land an Armalite on Temujin.
Oh boy. Uh-oh. He's a vulture, not a badger, you uncultured swine.
Baza is tired of this, climbing up to the top rope. Imogen looking a little unstable.
Oh no. Imogen, snap out of it!
Goes for a flying crossbody, but Temujin catches him up and slams him down with an Ushigoroshi.
Yes.
And it's a pin. One, two. Oh, but now Neon is able to break it up just at the last second. That would have been it right there if Neon hadn't broken it up. Gunter and Solstice. Looks like somebody got put through a table.
Get wrecked.
Oh, screw you, Benja.
CD.
I think it might have been Gunter who got put through the table.
I think so.
Was.
Oh, God. Come on, Temujin, come on! Ah, no!
And the Norris driver. Baza goes for the pin. One, two, three, and that's
yay!
It!
Yay!
I should have known this was too good to be true.
Get wrecked. Get wrecked.
By pinfall, the Trench Brothers.
Yeah. Get wrecked.
Who run it? You know the act. Party pops up, sister, come with me tonight. I ain't celebrating, I ain't snapping and popping either. I'm bobbing my head, or I'm just standing there watching. I'm a hustler, a hustle. You can tell that I'm coming in. I protect what I got. I'm in the house with my friends. Go get it. Okay, now maybe I'm sitting, cause I want you to trip. Yeah, I be on that shit. You should see when I'm flat. My friends start to be push the whips and be rolling. You can tell that I'm hollering. I'm just doing my thing. You know what I'm supposed to get. I got my grind, you shady with me. You front, you have to get me off your ass. A bit of lawsuit laugh. It's not a big deal, it's not a disadvantage. We run it. You know they're acting like you're down now. Yeah. I tell you,
we got
folks, yo. This flow got you in my dog. We got you in my dog. You know they're acting like you're down now. I tell you, flow got folks, yo. This flow is going to bring my dog. You know they're acting like you're down now. We got together to do this music and what we began in battle. We just developed the fellowship through it. There's no pretension. It's rich. I mean, and this is assuming. This is same for him. This is media. See the thing. This is image. This is the shit. It's no gimmicks. It's blood in and blood out. When it's me, you just gotta know when.
So far, one hell of a show. I've enjoyed every moment of it. And I hope you all have as well.
I think all of us enjoyed that, really.
Hello everyone, how is everyone doing tonight?
Hey,
Did everyone enjoy this weekend of shows here? I know, that's not how I normally address you, but I'm not out here tonight as the karma star you love to hate. I'm here as one of you, a fan of SL Pro Wrestling. I'm here as a long-standing member of the community, having been around for nearly 13 years altogether. For those who don't know, I also am the one who runs the sin here. Some here probably have noticed I'll drop down to see who's around the vendors from time to time. When I was asked about using this arena for the show, I could not say no to the request. This weekend is just another reminder of how short life can be. We are here to remember the time CJ was with us, and some have expressed how much CJ enjoyed the periodic, or the product overall, regardless of where she was watching. I had the pleasure of getting to face one of the few who CJ was probably closest to in the community before she had to step away, as I did remember seeing CJ Tyron managing Danny over at Premier a few times. CJ Tyron joins a few other very familiar and some very famous names among us who have gone on before us. Some may remember the names of Kamzy Moreland of Hawks way back. Petro Sheffield from DCWF, and I'm probably missing a few other names of those whom we have lost over the years. As this weekend comes to a close, though, I will invite the two people who asked me to help host this memorial. So please welcome the one who organized all of this, Vi Winchester, and her assistant, Stephen Calloway, to the ring. Let's hear it for these folks. This memorial show would not have happened.
You know, I have one more thing I gotta say. Can I get everyone from the back down here, please? And everyone that was involved yesterday,
No RWA this weekend. I've just been
informed. Danny, the Dominatrix, could you please come up here? Because I know CJ was your manager. So get in here, damn it. I gotta say this. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all the amazing talent that we had here yesterday and today. I want you guys to make the noise that CJ can hear from up above, please, because she wants to hear your cheers. Close up.
You guys know the song. You want to voice up? You may voice up this one time. That includes everybody in this ring as well. So, Violet, it's on you.
What? No.
No?
I'm not singing. No. Benji can sing.
Fine, I'll start it off.
Okay, go for it.
All right, everybody, 3, 2, 1. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
And many more on Channel 4.
And Scooby-Doo. And may you get plastered, you poor bad boy.